All right, guys, you know what time it is. It is time for more leaks. You know, this is going to happen for the next week or so. We're probably going to continue to get a trickle of information in here. You know, I'll make sure to cover it all as it comes in. But now, thanks, of course, to Team Dokkaner and the French data miners, we now know what exactly BPAN does. So big shout out to Team Dokkaner for putting the info out here. And of course, big shout out to Zaid Tabain for translating it for us. So let's jump in. Now this is kind of a big deal because this reveals several things. One, we get the full details for PAN. Two, PAN is actually the first unit we know of that has the active skill mechanic, which I'll talk about here in a second. And three, BPAN is also the first unit we know of that will actually be voice acted. So voices are officially coming to Dokkan. BPAN is going to be, you know, the first unit we know of that carries basically these two new things: active skills and the voice acting. So that's really cool. I really like that Dokkan, you know, typically I feel like Dokkan, what they would do is like, you know, LR Super Saiyan 4 Goku, right, is a big banner for the 4-year anniversary. And, like, he would be voice acted. He'd have an active skill. But then, like, you know, hey, pull him and get him so you could use the new mechanics. Otherwise, too bad. But now, they're giving this stuff to a free-to-play unit, right? Now, BPAN can be a bit of a pain to grind up because you can only do the event once per week. But, you know, if you've been playing for any length of time at all, you really should have BPAN. And now everyone will be able to test out the active skill mechanic and, you know, voices and stuff like that. So, BPAN is the first of the new gen cards to possess the active skill. Skills activatable manually under certain conditions. So, real quick, let's just look at what her active skill does. So, she gives all allies a 33% attack buff for one turn, activatable manually after three turns, you know, from the start of battle. So, really, you know, this does seem very, very similar to what Legends does with main abilities, where, you know, after a certain amount of time or whatever, you know, conditions have to be met, you can manually activate that. Of course, we know that's, you know, some transformations for certain characters, like, you know, Broly or Kaioken Goku over on Legends, or even, you know, Super Saiyan Shallot. You know, we could see similar things happen on Dokkan now. Like, you know, the transformation mechanic could potentially be an active skill in the future, which would be interesting. So, you know, I do like this, you know, having units now that have, like, certain abilities they could activate at different points. So, like, when you say that the gameplay of Dokkan would evolve during the 4th year anniversary, that does appear to be accurate. Because, you know, again, this one is pretty light. You know, it's a nice ability. Like, a 33, you know, for one turn, she becomes a really strong support type unit, right? 33% is very, very powerful. You know, think about some of the other active abilities we could see, you know. Let's say that a new UI Goku comes out and he gets, you know, after two turns, you can activate his active skill, which gives him 100% chance to dodge for two turns or something like that. Like, that would be very, very interesting. You know, there's a lot of this could, if they do it the right way, this could actually add a lot of strategy and make, you know, like, some of these Super Battle Road fights and stuff very, very fun. Because now there's, you know, more mechanics we have. But at the same time, this is good because this doesn't seem like this is one of those things. So, like, a lot of people like Dokkan compared to Legends for the fact that, you know, you could be at the gym working out on Dokkan. You know, you could watch a video and kind of, you know, do your turns on Dokkan. Dokkan is very easy to do whilst doing other things, eating, whatever you want. But Legends, right? Legends, you gotta be focused in. Like, especially if you're doing, like, PvP or something, you can't be focused on anything else. You gotta be honed right into Legends. So, you know, this active skill mechanic doesn't seem to me to be something that's going to interfere with that, you know, pro and con of Dokkan versus Legends, where Dokkan, it's not going to be more, like, you know, intensive where you have to focus on it, because, you know, you'll still know, okay, you know, after four turns, my GT Trunks will be able to activate his, you know, 75% defensive buff for that turn or something like that, right? So, you know, that stuff will be cool to have in the future. I presume both the voice acting and active skills will probably be restricted to newer cards for the time being, and then maybe they'll have future updates where they add these mechanics to other characters, you know, iconic, you know, units in the game, like LR Gogeta or Vegito. You know, I could see them getting the voice acting or an active skill or something like that. Also, ooh, now that I think about it, the way they changed how you look at cards in the game, I know exactly where the active skill part is going to come in, because on one of those pages, it's suspiciously, like, very, very empty. There's enough spot for them to put in something else in there, and that will go be where the active skills go. Okay, okay, okay. So, real quick, let's go ahead and take a look also at what Pan is able to do. So, Pan's HP is 16,000, attack basically 10,000, defense 8,200. So, I'm presuming that these stats right here, by the way, these are going to be B-Pan's base stats. Then she's probably just going to still have her B-rank potential system buffs. So her attack would probably go up to, what does she get, like 3,200 from attack? So I think her attack will be somewhere around, what, 14,000? Roughly about there, which should, that's actually, I think, going to be fine, considering what her abilities do. Her stats are definitely on the low end, but as long as this is not with orbs in them, she'll be fine, right? Like, she definitely is lower on the stats than a lot of other LRs, but LR's stats are so good that I don't think it's going to hurt B-Pan too much, right? Now, her leader skill, regen 3,333 HP when a character gets the same colored orb, so that's still fodder. That has not changed. Okay. Her 12-key super is colossal, you know, chance to stun. 18-key mega colossal with a medium chance to stun. So that, you know, should be pretty decent. She still has her chance to stun there, which is good. Of course, we already went over her active skill. You know, for one turn, she'll give that 33% attack buff. So that should be very, very handy on the team she's on. Again, we'll see. You know, again, we know that this is going to be a heavily themed, like, GT, you know, anniversary celebration, right? But we'll see if there's new category teams that might, you know, mix B-Pan onto a team with, like, Super Saiyan 4 Goku or something like that. Because right now, B-Pan is only usable on Hybrid Saiyans and Seekers of the Dragon Balls. So, you know, she's pretty much restricted to just the Hybrid Saiyans as a real category. So we'll see if she ends up becoming on one of these, a new category. I do think it's probably very possible. Her passive, so she regens 33% of damage inflicted, which, okay, that should be pretty good considering how high her attack stat is going to be. She should be able to do a pretty reasonable amount of damage, you know, with 14,000 attack. So, you know, her regening this HP combined with her stunning and then high or great chance of reducing damage by 55%. So they didn't give her massive buffs here, right? Like, only 3% on her recovery, only an extra 5% on her damage reduction. I really do hope this is a great chance, by the way. You know, a great chance or 70% chance would be very, very helpful for Pan for reducing damage, and that does make her a very strong unit. I love defensive units, and that would be exactly the type of thing that would make her very, very good as a defensive unit. Legendary power is replaced by more than meets the eye on her card. This, you know, in my Rainbow B-Pan video, I actually did predict that that's what they would do. They'd get rid of more than meets the eye. Because, again, with female units, Dokkan doesn't like them having too many attack links. So we couldn't possibly give her a third attack link. So I knew they had to get rid of either Innocence or more than meets the eye for Legendary Power. But obviously that is an upgrade. Legendary Power is much more, going to be much more easily for her to activate them. Like, dude, look at more than meets the eye. This link is fucking trash. Like, you're not, this isn't going to be really that good in most situations. Now, B-Pan will have legendary power over on that Hybrid Saiyan team where, guess what? You know, chances are you're going to be using some LRs. LR Trunks and Goten, this LR Trunks, that LR Trunks, you know, this LR Gohan. Chances are a lot of players will have them on their team. So that's a link that B-Pan will actually be able to activate, I think, quite consistently. So that should work out pretty well. Again, she does have Shattering the Limit. That'll allow her to work with some of those Hybrid Saiyan LRs too. So B-Pan is fine. She's definitely, like, free-to-play LR. I think she's very, very good for a lot of players to have. It's cool that she's introducing new mechanics into the game, the active skill, and the voices, right? But it's a free-to-play card. So everyone gets to kind of experience the new gimmicks or mechanics of the game. I think that was a very wise decision by Dokkan. I almost assuredly, right, you know, let's say we get LR Super Saiyan 4 Goku Banner, right, as one of them, like, he for sure would have voices, he'll have an active skill, you know, whatever these banner units end up being, you know, Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta, I'm even still seeing people say they hope it's like a LR UI Goku and Jiren. I think more towards GT characters is what we're gonna get, but I mean, you never know what they'll do, right? So, like, I do think those banner characters will have voices, they will also have the active skills, so I'm definitely looking forward to seeing all this happen, right? Like, the four-year anniversary is definitely rounding out to be very good. Right now, we're still getting we're getting a ton of stones as well as fourth-year anniversary tickets leading up to the actual anniversary itself. So things are looking good. You guys, let me know. What do you think of B-Pan? What do you think of the active skill mechanic? What do you think of the voices being added to Dokkan? Tell me about it all. Big shout-outs, of course, to Zaid Tabane, and then, of course, Team Dokkaner and the French Data Miners. Big ups to them. Thanks, y'all, for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.